Hi everyone, I'm excited to show you a new online tool that's just coming out to the public. I've been part of the beta testing for it and a bunch of other card makers and DIY and crafting people have been in this beta as well. And we've been using it for a while and it's really awesome. It's a great tool for bloggers. And it is the Inlinkz Link Manager. And it's exactly what it sounds like. It's aptly named because it manages all the links that you use on your blog. It's great if you have a lot of links that you link over to over and over again because it keeps them all in one place. But it's also really great to create kind of like a thumbnail collection of products out on the web that you want to share with your blog readers. That's mainly what I use it for, so I'm going to show you exactly how I do that. Before I get into how I do it, I'm going to show you an example on my blog of what it looks like. And I use the Inlinkz Link Manager for this particular blog post. And I just picked out lots of my favorite summertime crafting items. And using the Link Manager, I created this whole area on the page right here. And it's really awesome because I've done this on my own in the past, doing the whole HTML editing and all that and creating the images one by one. And it's time consuming and tedious. And the Inlinkz Link Manager is a solution for all of that frustration. So it's really awesome. And it makes it easy for any blogger. You don't even have to have an HTML background to do this. But if you do have an HTML background, you will appreciate it even more. So I'm going to jump over here, back over to the Link Manager. I'm going to show you how to do it. I'm going to add a new collection today by clicking on Add New Collection. I'm going to name it CHA Summer Favorites. I'm just going to show some of my favorites from the CHA releases. And under description, you could type in a new description if you want, but I tend to eliminate that and type a really lengthy description in the blog post. So in the Link Manager, I usually just copy and paste the description as the same thing as the name. Okay, so as far as columns and thumbnail size goes, you want to take into consideration the full width of your main column for your blog. Mine happens to be 600 pixels wide. So I know there's going to be a slight gap in between each thumbnail, needs a little bit of spacing around it. So I know I can't have like a ton of images spanning across that 600 pixels. I've discovered that the best configuration for me, if I want to have a lot of links, is to have 5 images across, so 5 columns, and have the thumbnails be 100 pixels wide. I'm going to click on display name because I want it to have a name underneath each image. But I'm going to keep text-only links unselected, and that's because I want those thumbnail images included. If I wanted to have just a list of like supplies for a project, or if I had a really lengthy list of links that I didn't want to include the thumbnails because it would just make it too cumbersome, I would go ahead and click on text-only links, and it would take out all the thumbnails. You would see the thumbnails in the Link Manager as you're creating your list, but when you export it and put it into your blog, it wouldn't have the thumbnails. Okay, so over here on the right side is some really awesome links. I'm going to take that filter out. Okay, so over here are all the links that I've used in previous collections. And so if I wanted to include some of these in this collection, I could just click and drag over. It's as easy as that. That's why it's so great for links you've already included and that you use often, because you can just page through all these links and just throw them right in there. It's also great because you can search for different links. Like if I want to find, let's see, some Lawn Fawn stamp sets, I can put that in and it'll find those stamp sets. And let's look for American Crafts. Oh, helps if I spell it right. Okay, so I've got some American Crafts paper and some stamps, things like that. Super easy to add all the links. Okay, so now I have some new items I'm going to add. I'm going to click over to 2Ps, and this is the Alphabet Pattern Cling Stamp from Studio Calico. I want to include this in my summertime favorites. So I'm going to come up to the top of the window, and I'm going to select that entire URL. I'll come back to the Inlinkz Link Manager. And I'm going to come to the top and I'm going to click on Add New Link. I'm going to paste in the URL like right away because I already have that on my clipboard. And then I'm going to go to select image. And this is the part that's just awesome, because this is where it takes out all the copying and pasting and photoshopping and cropping and all that, and it makes it super simple. I'm going to go to select from web page. I'll paste in that link or that URL, and it comes up with a window, and it will have every single image that's on that page, and I can select which one I want. So I'm going to select this one right here, and I'm going to unclick constrain aspect, and that's going to allow me to stretch this the boundary of the image to the top and bottom so that it'll show the entire image. I'll hit OK. And I'm going to come to the name here, and I'm going to put in alphabet pattern cling. Actually, I'm just going to do alphabet pattern stamp Studio Calico. And then I'm going to select that copy, and I'm going to paste it into the other areas. You can have different things. They can have it say different things. But just for simplicity's sake, I just always have it say the same thing. So go ahead and hit accept, and it adds, I have to take that filter off, it adds that link over here on the side. So now I can click and drag over to my collection. I can stick it in wherever I want. I'm gonna have it be the third item, put it right in there. And if I don't want any of these items, because you know these aren't the summertime releases, I can just hit the little trash can bucket next to them and get rid of all of them. It's actually pretty awesome. It's really easy. Okay, so my collection isn't done. I'm actually going to add a few more things to it. But for the sake of time for this video, let's pretend that I really am done. So I'm going to go to create, and that just saves the collection. I'm going to OK. And it takes me back to the main dashboard area of the Link Manager. You'll notice that my CHA Summer Favorites collection is at the top. Your most recent collections are added to the very top of the list. And every other collection that I've made is down below. So I'm going to show you a little bit what these icons are over here on the side. The little magnifying glass, or little, you know, little spy glass right there, is a preview. So it's going to show me what it looks like, all my links. If you hit the pencil, that's, you can edit the collection. It's going to take you back to that same page we were at before. Hit close. Where it has the two little A's here, that's if you want to edit the appearance of the collection. It's a little more in depth than the most people will ever need. In fact, I've never used it. But if you are particular about how your blog looks, you can definitely use that area and edit your collection even more. And right here is the very last thing you need to do before you put it on your blog, and that is you just need to grab all the code and script. So I'm going to click that, and if you want to keep things like really, really simple, you can just paste or copy all of this code right here and put it straight into your blog. And there are some directions right here if you need further directions. Down here you can select, it has all of the HTML code for that entire collection. It's already like figured out and built in. And this is the one I always use because it'll be visible in my like Google Reader feed and things like that. So it's a little more universal. So that's the one that I usually will copy and paste over into the HTML area in my blog. So that's how you create the collection. It's a really cool idea. And I'm totally surprised that no one has done this before, because it's kind of brilliant. So I'm really excited that I've been able to do this. Okay, so that is the Inlinkz Link Manager. Go ahead and try it out. It's free for an extended time, and you can just get a feel for it. It's really great for bloggers, especially if you want to do like thumbnail collections and things like that. So it's really great. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys next time.